Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at using and making your own guides in the Apple Maps app on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Apple Maps app has this feature called Guides, and you can view guides that already exist in the app. You'll see them come up when you search for certain places. You can also make your own. So for instance, let's start off with a simple search. And when I select Denver, I could see here that it pinpoints that location, the center of Denver. But also under information, I could see Denver guides. And there are a few here. So I've got hiking near Denver, most unique hotels and inns, and the best things to do in Denver. You could see two of those are from a place called Culture Trip and another one's from Time Out. Let's see what Time Out thinks are the best things to do in Denver. I'll click on that. You can see I come up with some pictures here. It gives me a description of this guide and I can scroll through it and see descriptions of places and photos. And if there's some place in particular that I want to check out, I can click on it and it shows me its location. Now if I like this guide and I want to keep it around, I can click here and select Add to My Guides. And now in the left here under My Guides, if I click to reveal that, I can see that guide here. So I can add any that I find that I want to keep. And the great thing is this syncs via iCloud. So on my iPhone, if I look in the Maps app under Guides, I'll find this one there too. There are also some other options here. For instance, I can go to See Publisher's Guides and it will show me other guides from that same publisher. I could see All Guides. So now I have a complete list. I can choose editor's picks or from specific locations. I can go to the publisher's website. I can also share a link to this guide or send it to another device. iCloud should do that automatically. Now anytime I want, I can return to this guide by clicking here and it will appear. But you could also make your own guides. To do that, first find a location. So let's say I want to make my list of things to do when somebody's visiting Denver. So I could search for something like this. It'll go to that and I could see here information about that and I could click here and say Save to Guide. And now I could select a guide I have created already or New Guide. So now it's going to create a new guide here and I can create this one. I could change the photo for it right here if I wanted to. But first let's add some more things. So let's go and search for some more things. And you can see I can easily save to guide and there's my guide there. And it adds that to the list. So I'll keep adding a few things. You don't have to search for things. You can actually find things on the map yourself and select them. So for instance, I can select this location here and add it. And I didn't have to search for it. Or I can control click or two finger click on a location, drop a pin there, and it will set it to a marked location. Now you can't name it right here, but if you go to add it to the guide, it will prompt you for a name. And then when you save it to the guide there, it's got that name. Now fortunately that's all you can really do to customize these. It would be nice if you could add a description as well and it could look more like the guides that you get from other sources. But all you can really do here is add locations. So one thing you can do is instead of using the actual location, I could two finger click right next to it, drop a pin, and then save that as a marked location to the guide and it will prompt me to add a name and then I can add a short description instead of a name. But other than that, the guide is really just a collection of locations. Note I can go and sort them here by name, distance from my current location, or date added. And then once you have a guide here, you can select it. You can see all the locations there. You can click the I button here and here you can change the photo. So I could select a photo from my images. I could also control click on it or two finger click on it and use share and share out a link. So for instance, if I choose mail here, it'll open up a new mail window with this link. It's a rather long link. So you may want to use a URL shortener or something. But look what happens if I select it and then use it in the browser. You can see it loads up in the browser without bringing up maps. So this will work even if the person isn't on a Mac. And here I get to see Apple Maps and I get to select any one of these locations here and it goes to it. hit the X to go back. So now I can send this around. When people ask me, hey, I'm visiting Denver, any recommendations of places to see, I can have this guide all ready to go. And maybe I can create one for my favorite restaurants. And if I'm going on vacation somewhere, I can go and look at some places that I want to go, maybe read some reviews of places, create my own guide, and then have access to that just for me while I'm traveling. Or maybe while I'm traveling, I create the guide and then I'm able to send people a quick link to the places that I enjoyed when I was visiting that location. In the iPhone, you can go into the Maps app and access the guides there. You can find them here at the bottom under My Guides. And then I can select one and I see a list underneath. I can sort them. I can jump to any one location very easily and even get directions right there. So it's handy to build this on your Mac and then use it later while you're on the go on your iPhone. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.